This video proves that most of the trees that Amey cut down are unnecessary tree killings.
One of the country's leading tree experts, Jeremy Barrell, has come to Sheffield to check out their troublesome trees.
Jeremy, what kind of problems can mature trees along a street like this cause?
Well, the main problem is going to be sort of damage to the surfacing and lifting up the pavement and also displacing the curb stones.
What can you do instead of cutting down the tree?
There's lots of flexible paving products that you can use to sort of build over the roots and allow them to grow and move.
This tree was among the eight to be axed, but was saved by the protesters. So what's Jeremy's expert opinion?
The disruption on this side of the pavement.
The pavement's a bit lumpy.
But it's minimal.
Yeah.
This is normal. It's the same where there aren't any trees. This is all stuff that the technical solutions, and it's just conventional stuff.
And on the road side?
Well, we do have some curb displacement there, but they just take out those two curb stones, and you've got another 10 or 20 years growth for the tree before it even starts to encroach on the highway.
The independent tree panel took the same view, yet the council, which had promised to listen to the panel's advice, ordered its destruction anyway. As we don't know exactly which trees will be next, Jeremy cast his expert eye over several currently in the council's sights.
Are there any trees along here that you think ought to be removed?
None from a health point of view. All the trees are okay, and from a safety point of view, they're fine.
What are your feelings on this one?
Well, you know, I've looked at every tree here, and none of them need to come out. This is contrary to government guidance. It's contrary to the professional guidance set out by the Chartered Institute of Highways and Transport. It's just a shocking affair that really we just have to try and make sure it doesn't happen anywhere else in the country.